Students, in the past few lectures, we have learned how to plot graphs, and we have even solved few example problems also based on how to find out velocity, acceleration from ST graphs, VT graph, when to use slope, and when to use area. So those are things we have discussed in the past previous lectures. And today we are going to solve one problem which is depending based on motion under gravity, right? Now the question is, plot distance displacement time graph, speed velocity time graph, and acceleration time graph for a body vertically projected up and for a body falling down freely. First, we will plot graphs for individual bodies which are being projected upward and projected falling down freely, and after that we will combine those two, and finally we will plot graph for the whole journey going up and as well as down. So in this video session, like, we will be completing this total part because it is nearly 10 graphs you should plot for this. What are they? ST graph, S bar T graph, VT graph, V bar T graph, and AT graph. This is for body thrown up. For body thrown up, you have 5 graphs. Similarly, for body falling freely, falling down freely, you have 5 graphs. So totally 10 graphs you need to plot for this question. So those 10 graphs we will plot for this question, and after that, for the whole journey, we need to plot again 5 graphs. So totally 15 graphs we will be plotting in order to answer this question. So be careful with this, because we are dealing with vector quantities and as well as scalar quantities. So remember that distance is a scalar quantity, speed is a scalar quantity. Scalar quantities are always positive values. There will be no negative values for scalars. They are always positive. And acceleration is a vector quantity, so it should be taken in terms of vector only. So these things you need to keep it in your mind when you are dealing with these graphs. So first, let us plot graph for body vertically projected upward. Distance time graph we will plot now for body vertically projected up. Vertically projected up, for this you will plot ST graph. Now see here, you have a body and this is being projected upward with some velocity whose initial velocity is non-zero. U is not equal to 0, and it goes to some height, and this is h maximum. It travels some maximum height, and finally when it comes over here, final velocity becomes 0 when it is going upward, right? And acceleration due to gravity, it is in downward direction. Acceleration due to gravity is pointed downward. Now in order to solve, we will be considering upward directions. Upward direction, take it as negative, and downward direction you take it as positive. This is the reference I am giving you. Upward directions, all upward directions which you are handling with, you need to take them as positive, and downward take it as negative. And what are upward in this? Upward direction is displacement. Displacement is negative because body is going upward. Similarly, velocity, body is going upward, so velocity is also negative. And next is acceleration. Acceleration is in which direction? Downward. So you will be taking it as positive. Okay. And distance is a scalar. Similarly, speed is also scalar. Therefore, you need to take them as positive. Scalar quantities, you will be treating it as only positive values, whereas vector quantities, you need to treat them as positive or negative. That depends on the direction. And here, reference I am giving you, upward direction, you should take it as negative. Downward direction, you should take it as positive. Now, using these simple directional quantities, we will be plotting graphs. First, ST graph. So when you are plotting ST graph, ST, distance is a scalar quantity. So as it is a scalar quantity, your time is taken on x-axis. Distance is in meter. S and T both are positive. So therefore, you will get graph in first quadrant. S and T both are positive. So you will be getting graph in the first quadrant. And see, when the body is going up, acceleration due to gravity is non-zero. And this is non-uniform motion. This is non-uniform motion because acceleration is non-zero, right? For non-uniform motion, ST graph is curved, right? So ST graph is curved. So first thing we have learned, ST graph is curved, but when it is curved, we have two cases again, whether it is increasing slope or decreasing slope. If it is increasing slope or decreasing slope, so ST graph is curved, which you have got information from this because it is non-uniform motion. This is curved graph. And slope either increase or decrease, that you can decide with velocity. Okay, so slope decreases since speed decreases. Is it not? When the body is starting at the initial position, its velocity is maximum. And then when it goes to highest point, what is happening to velocity? It is zero. Speed is also becoming zero. So therefore, velocity is decreasing or speed is decreasing. Therefore, what you need to draw graph in such a way that slope should be decreased. So slope is decreased and the time taken is time of ascent. And the maximum height covered, H maximum. This is H maximum covered. Now I should plot the graph. So how I should plot the graph? Body is starting at initial position and at the time of ascent, it is at maximum height. This is the point where finally it is reaching. And this is the initial point where it is starting. H is zero. And finally it is reaching at maximum at time of ascent. Now you need to plot a graph in such a way slope decreases. So slope decreases in the sense you should get a graph like this. Slope is decreasing. Therefore, velocity decreases. This is ST graph for your body vertically projected upward. Okay, next number two. S bar, that is displacement time graph. This is displacement time graph we are plotting now. When you are plotting displacement time graph, remember that it is a vector quantity, right? So displacement, when you are dealing with vector quantity, care should be taken that in which quadrant you get this graph. Displacement, it is in which direction? Upward. And upward direction, I am considering it as negative. Time is positive, right? So displacement, y coordinate is negative. X coordinate is positive. Therefore, you will be getting graph in the fourth quadrant. This is time axis and this is displacement and it is in meter. And here is origin. This is time of ascent. So when the body is going up, initially displacement is zero. Finally, at the time of ascent, it comes to maximum height, H maximum. And as it is in upward direction, you are considering it as negative. It is vector quantity. Upward, I am taking it as positive. And the point of projection is origin. Here I am considering it as origin. Now, as bodies are going upward, I am considering it as negative. So therefore, you will get graph like this. So check it up how I will plot the graph. It is first, it is starting at zero. And when it is going up, slope should decrease. Slope should not increase. Slope should decrease. So as a result, you will be getting a graph like this. Right? This is S bar T graph with slope decreasing. And this is in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant, because displacement is negative, time is positive. As this first graph, ST graph, is in first quadrant, because it should be noted that both S and T are positive. But in the second graph, displacement is negative. That is the reason why you are getting graph in the fourth quadrant, right? So this is about ST and S bar T graphs. Next. Now we have one more thing. You should plot V bar and VT graph. Okay. So first let me plot VT graph. Speed time graph. And speed time graph, both are positive. So in which quadrant you will be getting graph? First quadrant you will be getting the graph. And it is non-uniform motion, but with uniform acceleration. It is with uniform acceleration. For uniform acceleration, VT graph is a straight line passing through origin. Okay, so using these hints, we should now plot the graph. So it is non-uniform motion, but uniform acceleration. For uniform acceleration, VT graph is a straight line passing through the origin. Okay, now I'll plot the graph. Speed and time both are positive. So it is V in meter per second and time in second. So it is VT graph. Therefore, you will get a straight line. And straight line in such a way, check it up, when the body is going up, initial velocity is maximum, not equal to zero. Final velocity is equal to zero. So initially, when the time t is equal to zero, body is having some value. What is its value? It is u. And when time t is equal to time of ascent, its velocity is becoming zero. Therefore, you should get a graph like this. I'm sorry. It should be a straight line. One thing I'll do, I'll mark this with a straight line. Okay, so this is a straight line which gives you UT graph. Maximum velocity is initially, so it's starting from maximum value and finally it is tending to zero. This is speed time graph. Next, coming to velocity time graph. Velocity. And velocity is in which direction? Upward. And upward direction, I am considering it as negative. Velocity time graph, I am plotting now. So as y coordinate, it is negative, time is positive. So you will be getting graph in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. You will be getting graph in the fourth quadrant, because velocity, as it is in upward direction, you are taking it as negative. Now you can plot graph. It is V in meter per second and it is time in second. I'm sorry, this should be in fourth quadrant, right? So as it is fourth quadrant, this is fourth quadrant. And here it is origin. This is V meter per second and time in second. Initially, when time t is equal to 0, body is having maximum velocity, that is u. And when time it have reached time of ascent, body is having a zero value. So therefore, you will be getting a graph like this. Right? So it is in fourth quadrant, it is in first quadrant. Only that is the difference. And remember, it is not uniform acceleration. So you'll be getting a straight line in case of UT graph. Okay. Next, number three, third graph. It is acceleration time. Sorry, fifth. Acceleration time graph. Now, acceleration is uniform. Acceleration is g, it is 9.8 meter per second square, and it is in which direction? Downward. As it is in downward direction, g and t both are positive. G and t are positive. So you will be getting graph in which quadrant? First quadrant, you will be getting the graph. And remember, it is uniform acceleration. This is uniform acceleration. For uniform acceleration, you can plot graph this way. It is time in second, and it is acceleration in meter per second square. And you'll be getting a graph like this, whose value is 9.8 meter per second square. And it is fixed at any particular time. So AT graph is a straight line parallel to time axis. That is the final conclusion. Understand carefully, we are plotting graphs for body falling down freely. When the body is falling down freely, velocity gradually increases with respect to time. So displacement, velocity, acceleration, all are in downward direction. You are taking them as positive. And body is in non-uniform motion, but it is moving with uniform acceleration. So ST graph, if you plot, distance time graph, if you plot, initially body is at h distance. Initially body is at h distance. And after time of descent, body is coming to distance zero, because you are taking ground as the reference. Okay. So as you are taking ground as the reference, you will be getting a graph in such a way, slope should increase, because when the body is falling down freely, velocity increases. So therefore, slope should increase. So you will be getting a graph like this. Right? So at time of descent, it is coming to the ground. It is falling from height h and it is reaching the ground. So therefore, as it is non-uniform motion, ST graph is a curved graph with slope decreasing. Sorry, slope increasing. Slope increase. This is ST graph. Next, second one, it is S bar T graph. Right? S bar, it is positive. Time is also positive. Therefore, you will be getting graph in first quadrant itself. Okay? Because S bar and T bar both are positive, you will be getting graph in the first quadrant. This is S bar, it is in meter, time, this is in second. And of course, displacement is also same. It is starting from H position and it is coming to zero. So therefore, you will be getting a graph like this. This is time of descent. Both ST and S bar T graphs are similar. ST and S bar T are similar, because direction of displacement is also in the direction of speed, sorry, in the direction of distance. So distance and displacement both are alike. That is the reason why here you are getting graphs same way. Two graphs are same. This is ST graph and S bar T graphs. Now you should plot VT graph and as well as V bar T graphs. Coming to VT graph. So speed is positive, time is also positive, Therefore, you will be getting graph in first quadrant, right? So as you are getting graph in the first quadrant, this is v meter per second, time in second. Initially, velocity is zero, and when time reaches time of descent, its velocity is maximum. This is v, and at this time of descent, it is having a value of v. And remember, this is uniform acceleration, so you will be getting a straight line like this. Velocity increases with respect to time, uniform acceleration. And uniform acceleration is g, which is 9.8 meter per second squared. That is fixed. So that is the reason why you are getting a vt graph, which is a positive value, and it is a straight line passing through the origin. Next, coming to another graph, v bar t graph. This is number 3 and number 4. V bar t. What about v bar? V bar is positive. Time is also positive. Therefore, you will get graph in first quadrant itself. Right? Now, if I plot graph for this, time is in second. V bar, it is in meter per second. Initially, it is starting at rest position. And finally, when it reaches the time of descent, it will be having a fixed value. And that is V. Right? So here, this is uniform acceleration. So G value, it is fixed at 9.8 meter per second square. And remember, VT and V bar T are similar. Right? This is number 4. Now last one. Number 5. What is fifth one? Acceleration time graph. You should plot acceleration time graph. Acceleration time graph. What about acceleration? It is positive because it is in downward direction. Time is also positive, and therefore you will be getting graph in the first quadrant. So plotting the graph, acceleration is in meter per second square and time is in second. And remember, acceleration is a fixed value. G, this is 9.8 meter per second square. Acceleration, as it is constant value at any particular time, its value does not change. You will be getting a graph, straight line, whose value is 9.8 meter per second square. This is how you can plot ST, S bar T, VT, V bar T, and A bar T for the body projected upward and as well as body falling down freely. In this particular slide, we are plotting graphs for body being projected upward for the total journey till it reach ground. We are plotting the graphs. That means it is just the combination of last two cases. So when the body is going up, velocity decreases. When the body is coming down, velocity increases. So for the whole journey, you need to now plot the graph. So total time is equal to time of ascent plus time of descent. And initially its velocity is u. Finally, when it comes to the same level, its velocity will be v, and same value u. And when it is at the highest point, see, v maximum at this point is equal to zero. So velocity at this particular point will be equal to zero at the maximum height. Now I need to plot graphs for this. One by one graph I'll plot. Pay attention. First is ST graph. Okay, ST, distance time graph. When you are considering distance time graph, when the body is going up or when the body is coming down, S is positive. Distance is positive always. Time taken is also positive always. Therefore, you will be getting graph in the first quadrant, and that graph will be seen like this. It is distance in meter, time taken in second. And remember, initially body is starting at rest position. When it is time of ascent, it is reaching to the highest point. This is time of ascent and this is time of flight. And when it is at time of ascent, it is reaching height h. Now you plot the graph. So how to plot the graph? Remember, it is non-uniform motion. So first velocity decreases when the body is going upward. So when velocity is decreasing, slope should decrease. Slope should decrease. Slope is decreasing. Next, when it is again reaching back to the ground, check it up. It is traveling distance 2h. While going up, it is h. While coming down, it is h. Totally, what is the total distance traveled by the body? It is 2h. So that is the reason why when it is at time of flight, it is at this position 2h, and when it is coming down, slope should increase. So you will be getting a graph like this. Clear? This is while coming down, and this is while going upward. And totally it is ST graph, and remember it is in first quadrant. This is graph one. Now coming to the next one. S bar T graph. Second one, it is S bar T graph. Remember, when the body is going upward, you should take it as negative. When the body is coming down, it is positive. So first half of the journey, S is negative. Second half of the journey, S is positive. So you will be getting graph in the first quadrant and as well as fourth quadrant. This is minus S bar. And this is plus S bar. It is in meter. And this is time. It is in second. Initially, body is starting at the origin. It is going to some height h, right? And when the body is going up, it is taken as negative. So that is the reason why you should start graph from here. Body is starting from rest and it is traveling a distance h, and that is negative. So when body is at time of ascent, here this is time of ascent, it is reaching a distance of minus S bar, and with slope decrease, slope should decrease. So therefore you will be getting a graph like this, with slope decreases. This is the slope decreasing with respect to time. This is first half of the journey. Now coming to the next half of the journey, what would happen? Body is again coming back to its original position. So it is time of flight. Body is again coming to the same displacement and it is zero. When coming down, its slope should increase. Right? I'm sorry, let me make it clear. This is right. So from S bar, it is when it is coming down. Oh, I'm sorry. See, check it up. S bar, when it is coming down, S bar, you need to take it as positive, right? So it is S bar. S bar positive. And when it is coming down, its slope should increase. You will get a discontinuous graph. You will get a discontinuous graph because when the body is going upward, displacement is negative. When the body is coming downward, displacement is positive. That is the reason why at the time of ascent, immediately displacement from negative value, it tend to positive. That is the reason why you will be getting a graph which is discontinuous. And this is S bar T graph. Next, coming to third one. It is VT graph. Speed time graph. Speed time, both are positive. So therefore you will be getting graph in first quadrant. Right? And check it up how you will be getting here. Velocity, speed is in meter per second. Time is in second. Initially speed is zero. This is time of ascent. And this is time of flight. Initially speed is zero. And remember, VT graph is a straight line passing through. VT graph, it should be a straight line that depends upon motion of the body. So acceleration is uniform in this case. Initially, it is starting with maximum value. It decreases till it reaches time of ascent. And this is U and this is zero. And finally, when it is coming down again, velocity increases. So finally, it is reaching the same value. This is speed time graph. This is first half of the journey, and this is second half of the journey. Next, fourth one, V bar T graph. And when it is V bar T graph, remember that first half of the journey, it is in the fourth quadrant. Second half, it is in the first quadrant. This is fourth quadrant, and this is first quadrant. It is plus V, and this is minus V, and it is time taken T. Initially, body is starting at maximum value, and it is at the time of ascent. This is time of ascent, it reaches zero. Next, after reaching time of ascent, when body is coming down, velocity is positive because its direction changed. So therefore, you will be getting a straight line graph like this in the first quadrant. This is plus V, and this is time of flight. And this is the fourth. Now coming to the last one, AT graph, acceleration time graph. And when it is acceleration time graph, acceleration is uniform and always it is positive. So acceleration due to gravity, it is downward, therefore positive. Time taken is also positive. You will be getting graph in the first quadrant, right? So if you plot graph, this is acceleration in meter per second square. Time is in second. And if you plot graph, you will be getting a straight line with value 9.8 meter per second square. And this is fixed. This is how for whole journey of your body going up and falling down. These are the graphs which you can plot. ST, S bar T, speed time graph, velocity time graph, and acceleration time graph. All of them are not equal because distance displacement, one is vector and the other one is scalar. So when you are plotting vectors, you need to take direction into consideration and positive and negative values. Depending on that, you may get graph in the fourth quadrant or you may get graph in the first quadrant. So students, as we know, time is positive. Time is a scalar quantity. And it is always positive, right? And remember, time cannot be returned back. Time will not be negative and you will not get time reversed back. So keeping those in mind, there are a few graphs which are not possible in kinematics. That is number one. Either you can take S bar or V bar or A bar. And here it is time taken. This graph is not possible. Why this graph is not possible? See, at any time will not be constant at any time. Not constant. So never time is constant. Time is not constant at all. At anywhere, time will not be constant. But in this graph, if you see, it is observed that time is constant. So therefore, this graph is never possible. That is number one. Number two. S bar or V bar or A bar, whatever you can take it on the y axis, time taken is here. This kind of graph is not possible. What is, why it is so? See, check it up. If I mark two vertical points, this is time T1, this is time taken T2. Now at time T1, it is cutting two. It is crossing three points, right? Here one, and this is two, and this is three. What does it represent? Same time, different positions. Same time, different positions. So at the same time, do body have different positions? Obviously not at all possible. So therefore, this is also not possible at all. That is number two. Next, coming to number three. This is V bar or S bar or T and A, and here it is time taken T. Such type of closed graphs will not be possible in kinematics. This is a reversible graph. So in this case, time is reversed, right? Time is reversed. Therefore, this kind of graph is also not at all possible in kinematics. This is also not possible. Fine. So these are very important things you need to learn. These are graphs which are not at all possible. Depending on the time, you can decide which graph is possible and which is not possible.